Welcome back. So our other algebraic method is called the addition method. You may have learned this under the title the elimination method, because when we're done with the first step, it eliminates one of the variables. But technically, when we're done with the first step in the substitution method, it eliminated one of the variables. So the book likes to call this one the addition method because that is what you do. We're going to add. Now, in order to add, we need to have the equations in the same format. Like technically, I can add any two equations I want. If they are equal, then adding equal things to equal things preserves the balance. So if you think of it literally as a two-pan balance, I have it balanced. I have a second set of scales, they are balanced. If I take the second set and dump everything from it into the first step, it will still be balanced. So I can add any equations I want. But here, in order to make use of the strategy, we want to have them in this format first. And this is actually getting you set up to be able to do matrices later. Matrices require them to be in this format because they exploit the format. And we are literally going to be doing the same thing. Like matrices are actually just the shorthand of doing the addition method. All right, so I need it to be x's and y's on one side in order, number on the other. So 2x minus 9y equals 1, good. 3x equals 17 minus 2y, nope. So we need that 2y back on the other side. So I'm going to add it over. And then I'm going to write them both here. And then 3x's, here, hold on, let me use a second color. 3x's plus 2y's equals a huge 17. All right. Now, if there's any fractions or decimals, you can multiply to clear those out. In other words, if you see fractions, multiply to clear the denominators. We don't want you to actually work through these with fractions. They're ugly. And a lot of times when you clear the fractions, the resulting equations like are already set up for the addition method. All right, so what we want now is we want to set it up so in step four here, we can add the equations so that one of the variables is going to add to zero. So I need to turn my coefficients into a pair of numbers that add to zero. So I've got 2 and 3 or -9 and 2. Negative 9 is the biggest or furthest number from zero, so I don't want to use it. So I'm going to stick with the 2 and the 3. So I need a number larger than 2, larger than 3, that both of those divide into, or a number bigger than them that I can figure out what number I need to multiply to get to that. Worst comes to worst, if you're not sure, just multiply the two numbers. 2 times 3 is 6. So now, we are going to set them up for the addition method. So I'm going to multiply everything in the first equation by 2 times 3 would get me to 6. In the second equation, it would be 3 times 2. Now there's a catch. I need them to add to 0. Right now, they would both multiply to positive 6x. I need one of them to be negative. Doesn't matter which one is negative, just have to make one of them negative. Now, if we had been multiplying on the y's, they would already be opposite signs. We wouldn't have to worry about this. But since our x's are starting as the same sign, they're both positive, one of the numbers we multiply by needs to be negative. When in doubt, I make the second one negative. It really doesn't matter, though. It'll still work out if you make the first one. All right, now we multiply. 2x times 3 becomes 6x. -9y times 3 becomes -27y. The numbers can look big, they work out. And then over here equals 1 times 3 is 3. So don't freak out if you're getting big numbers here. Freak out if you get a fraction when you finish this. And if you do, 9 times out of 10, it's because you forgot to multiply the last number. Like people will remember to do the X's and the Y's, but then they'll forget 1 times 3 is 3. And they'll write a 1 over here, and now they're solving a totally different system that'll have an ugly answer. Now here, 3x going through and multiply by negative 2 is negative 6x's. 2y's being multiplied by negative 2 is negative 4y's. And 17 times negative 2, well, we know it's going to be negative, and that is 34. All right, now this is where we add. I have an equation and another equation set up in a format I like, I choose. Now I am going to add vertically. So 6x's plus negative 6x's, poof, 0. No x's, no nothing. Technically, we don't even have to write the 0, but it's our first time doing it, so consistency. The negative 27y's minus 4 more y's gets more negative. Negative 31y. Then 3 minus 34 moves us a little bit closer back towards 0. And negative 31. All right, and look at that. Negative 31, negative 31, yes. So just because the numbers start looking ugly, keep going. So 0 minus 31y, like I said before, the 0 doesn't do anything here. 0 minus 31y is negative 31y. And then we're just going to divide. So we get y is positive 1. That is only half the answer, though. Now, we must solve for the other half. We have y, we need x. So we need to take that back to an equation. Doesn't matter which equation. I am going to go with this one because it's almost solved for x. So that'll be 3x's equals 17 minus 2 times 1. So that is 2 times 1 is 2, 17 minus 2 is 15. And we get 5 for the x. Now if I substitute 5 comma 1, into the first equation and into the second equation, it will work in both equations. So that's why the very first question we did, example one, was determine if this is a solution, is because that's how you can check any of these. All right. We're gonna do one more addition method, get y'all comfortable with that. And then what we have after that is word problems. I'll make those separate videos because they're word problems. I apologize. But now we can use the two variables that the book was desperately trying not to use when we did these at the beginning of the semester. I know. Oh, I needed to leave some room. Oh, I forgot we got weird stuff. Of course, this is also weird looking. So we have two different y terms in the first equation, and we got fractions in the second equation. So this is the like Frankenstein of questions. They put all the different pieces in here. So the first one, we need to math it around and get the variables on one side, any number part on the other. The second equation, we need to get rid of the ugly fractions. So that is where we're gonna start. So here, I'm gonna distribute that 2. So it is 2x minus 4y equals y plus 14. And then I need to minus the y. So we have 2x's minus 5y's is equal to 14. All right, there's one of our equations in standard form. X and y on one side, number on the other, a, b, c. Now, this ugly equation up here, I want to get rid of those fractions. I don't want to try this method with fractions. It is ugly. Don't want to do it. Likewise, if you want to try to graph these, first thing, get rid of the fractions, then solve it for y. So I need a number that 2, 3, and 6 all divide into, or the common denominator between 2, 3, and 6 is 6. So we're going to multiply everything by 6. So that is both sides, which means that 6 is going to distribute through. So I'm going to cheat and do that. That looks like an exponent. There. Still looks pretty bad, but better. All right. Oh, don't do this. All right, here we go. 6 times a half, half of 6 is going to be 3x. And then that was a plus 6 times 7/6 will just be 7y's. Then 3 goes into 6 two times. Negative 13 times 2 is negative 26. So there's our two equations. I'm going to write this one underneath the other. 3x's plus 7y's equals negative 26. Ugh. I say because for each of these, one doesn't easily turn into the other. I need to think of a bigger number to multiply them both up to. Could do the X's. I'm actually deliberately going to choose the Y's because they're harder, they're bigger numbers. So we're going to get bigger results. Why do you do this, computer? There. Sure. Go to a different screen and come back. Yeah, obviously that's the solution. Guess that's the equivalent of turning it off and on again. All right. So the number that 5 and 7, a bigger number, a multiple of them, is 5 times 7, 35. So I want to figure out what I multiply 5 by to get to 35. That is 7. Likewise, what do I multiply the 7 by? 5. They are already opposite signs, which is the other reason I'm choosing to focus on them. So I don't have to multiply one of these by a negative. It's only, we only do that if they start the same sign. If both of these were negative, then one of my numbers over here would have to be negative that I'm choosing to multiply by. All right, let's go ahead and crunch that. So 7 times 2 is going to be 14 X's. The numbers are going to get even bigger. Minus 35 Y's. And then 7 times 14, that's 7 times 7 times 2, 49 times 2, 98. Yes, I do too much mental math. Then here, 15 X's. So we're going to get 19 X's. Ooh, I hope this works out. Sarcasm, it always works out. All right, and then 5 times negative 26. Well, it's definitely negative. And that's 5 times 20 is 100. 5 times 6 is 30, so 130. Now we add, like I said before, that is, 29 X's. Then over here equals 98 minus 130. Really? So there's 30 and 2 more. I'm getting negative 32, and I'm not liking it because negative 32 over 29 is hideous. Yes, it was a plus. Well, it's not impossible for us to get a fraction answer. It's just rare. All right. I'm going to leave that. And this one we're going to check because I don't like that answer. My gut is like, no, 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 that can't be the answer. That is hideous. Really is. All right. Now where to put that disgusting mess? Yeah. Guess we're going to go back to this one. So this is going to be a horrendous mess where I highly recommend using a calculator with a fraction function that I don't have. Negative 96 over 29. I'm going to add that. Which is going to give us a ridiculous number, and then we divide that result by 7. I hate it when there's a mistake. Now we see if the calculator on my phone. We'll do the fractions because I really don't want to do that by hand. All right, 96 divided by 29 minus 26, that divided by 7 equals this. Negative 3.241379, blah, 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 blah. So it looks like it's going to be negative 94/29 probably. All right, I'm going to put a pin in this one, figure out where my typo is. And I may have to re-record the second video. Okay. You know what? I'm just going to just